Hey everybody, this is John with Splitting Sticks. Today, we're gonna do something a little bit different. I'm gonna show you what I did to upgrade the pump on my North Star 31 gallon pull behind sprayer. So it's gonna be a little bit of a review, but on that sprayer here at my property, I have like an acre of where the house is and a yard and everything. And I bought this to spray weeds and you know, just anything that I need to do. Back here in the wood yard, I had some grass area, and every year I get tired of having to mow it all the time. So I used it to spray some weed and grass killer for those parts, because I want to at some point bring in gravel and just gravel everything. But I'll give you a little overview of it right now. This is the sprayer. It's a North Star 31 gallon pull behind sprayer, and it you know, does pretty good. But the one thing that it comes with a 2.2 gallon per minute sprayer. And every video out there that says if you buy the 31 gallon to upgrade that pump. And I agree with that, because I pull it on my zero turn, and the lowest speed on that, the 2.2 gallon per minute spray, is just, it's hard to, you gotta go really slow for that to get good coverage. So what I did was I looked, and everybody says go to a, upgrade the pump to a 4 gallon per minute. Or I noticed they also have a 5.5 gallon per minute, but I didn't want to do that. So I went with the North Star 4 gallon per minute pump. Okay, but the problem I had was the 2.2 gallon pump that it comes with. It bolts right on, you know, everything, but it has quick connect fittings everywhere. So when I bought the 4 gallon per minute pump, it didn't have the quick connect fittings. And so, and it's a bigger pump, so the hole for the return line, you have to space it out and cut another hole. Now, that's no big deal. But what I found was, you know, one person says, oh, you can just silicone the quick connect fitting into the pump and you should be fine. And so I tried doing that, and that, I believe, is the one side. That's the pickup side. And I went ahead and siliconed that, and that was fine. This inlet right here is threaded, and this one right here is threaded going into the valve. And so I tried siliconing it. I tried different things, and it just did not work, because the thread going into a quick connect fitting, it just always blew out, and it was pissing me off. So the one thing to make it easy for everyone, if you're going to do this upgrade, the one thing that I found that was the easiest was go on the website of Northern and look for Universal AG sprayer parts, pump fittings, quick attach kit. Now, with this kit, it comes with a bunch of like four different fittings. And the one you want is the 3/8 MPT female quick attach. Okay, that's the one in that kit. But then what you're gonna find out is that part of it fits into the regulator, but it's 3/8 inch female, so then you need an adapter for that. And the easiest way to do that was, what I found was, I went to the hardware store, okay, because the pump itself on this side and this side are half inch openings. So that quick connect fitting fits onto the regulator good, but that is has 3/8 male. So to save yourself a lot of time, order that quick connect kit and then go to your hardware store and find this bushing. This is a hex bushing. It's brass, but it's 1/2 inch MIP by 3/8 FIP. FIP is female, 1/2 inch MIP is male. Then that screws right into that quick connect fitting, and then the brass fitting goes right into the pump. And that solved all of my problems. One thing I tried doing too was I found a 1/2 inch, like a PVC, if you can see that white piece in there, 1/2 inch PVC, but it was smooth on the inside. And I tried using the regulator to put in there and then silicone that or glue that in to that PVC, and it still blew. It just did not work well at all. So, but if you take your time and you order this, it'll save you a lot of frustration, because I was getting pissed off. You know, you think you got it. I gooped it up even better. I used some Gorilla glue and tried to do it, and it still blew it out. So the intake doesn't have any pressure on it, so I just left that. I bought two of those brass fittings just in case. I haven't had to use that at all yet, but measure twice, cut once, and then for your holes, that's not so bad. It is bigger, so it doesn't fit all the way down into the tank coming from that regulator. The regulator is not very good. It has enough pressure in there, but when I use it to decrease the pressure or increase the pressure, the gauge really doesn't move. It doesn't do anything. So another thing I had to do was, where you hook it up to the battery, it's got a quick attach there. I had to put on a different one that I had, because it worked fine at first. I used it a couple times and I looked back, and if you don't use dye in your liquid, in your weed killer or whatever you're doing, it's hard to see when you turn back riding the lawnmower and look back, it's hard to see that spray. And there's times it wasn't even going. So then I'd look at the pressure gauge on the regulator and it nothing was spraying out. So I would mess with that. I thought it was the clips at one point, but then I just, you know, wiggled that adapter around and it would kick on, and then let go of it, it would kick off. So it was bad. And I had another one from something else that was broke. So I just cut that and then soldered it on, taped it up, and it is good to go. But as far as the sprayer goes, people had problems when they got it. There's a shutoff right here, and then the sprayer tip is right there. They said that a lot of these hose clamps weren't tightened down, weren't leaking. There's a lot of leaks everywhere. And I found that not to be the case with mine. So I just, you know, just make sure you make sure all those are tight. The only thing that I ran into was the quality of these little hose clamps are not very good. So, but as far as spraying width, I don't have it full of liquid. I'm not gonna show you the spray, but from the end of the spray on both sides, so the total width of the spray, you know, there's a fan, it sprays out in a fan pattern. I would say it's a good 8 to 10 feet width when you have both arms extended going full blast. It does pretty good. And so it's got that. I upgraded the wand on it too. The wand that comes with it is not very good. It's pretty cheesy, cheap. So I just upgraded that too as well. And I've used it. It works pretty good. But as far as the quality of it for the price you pay, I think it's a little expensive for what you pay, but it gets the job done. So, do I regret buying it? No, because it does work. So I used it around the wood yard. As you can see, this was all totally green. And I used it to put some killer down in it, and it worked good. So, but like I said, if you've got just like a normal John Deere or whatever rider, it should be fine because you can go slow. If you want to go faster, you're going to have to upgrade the pump. And I would recommend doing that. The 4 gallon per minute seems to do pretty good. You don't run out of, if you fill it up, it lasts a long time. I usually go to about 20 gallons. Just to make sure. I haven't used it. I've only used it like twice, so I haven't really filled it up to the whole 31 gallons, but it does a good job for what it is. So I hope that helps some people out there that are looking for the North Star 31 gallon videos. I know I did, looked around a lot, and yeah, so, but it does good. So I'll probably title this as such, but that is it for now. Like I said, I'll get back to the firewood videos, but just wanted to do a quick one on this. And thanks for watching. Like and subscribe, and we'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.